neighborhood. We usually do this the second Saturday of every month, and because it was so hot, we actually were trying to avoid it. But now it's cooled off. We need to get in the neighborhood. We need to be praying with people. And Alex and Daisy had come to me, what, about 2 or 3 weeks ago now about it. And one of the things we want to do is not just knock on doors and pray with people, but we want to go, like, just pray around the neighborhood, corner to corner, because we really need to. There's a reason why this church struggles with growth. And I have to be honest, it's not the people here teaching and stuff, because I've been to other churches, and you guys are outstanding. And I'm not trying to give you big heads, but you guys are outstanding teachers. The love here you can't find in other places. It's amazing. It's so genuine that I can't believe that people aren't just clinging to it, you know? So it's going to be a matter of us. The Bible is very clear that the battle's not against flesh and blood. And I really believe that. Okay, we need to be out here praying. And we need to pray that God opens doors. I was talking about something in Sunday school, and it came back to me. I don't want to take a bunch of time, but when Paul went into Philippi, nobody wanted to hear him. Nobody wanted anything to do with him. And he told the men that were with him, "We need to go find a quiet place to pray." So he went outside the village to pray, outside the town to pray. And while they were out there, they began to pray. But what they went out there to pray for was that God would open a door to ministry in that place. And it seemed like an impossible place for that to take place. But they went out and they prayed. And you know what was going on? Women were out there washing their clothes. See, and one of them was a very prominent woman in the community. And she heard the gospel and gave her life to Christ. And they began a church in her home. So God opened that door. I've been in ministry 20-something years now, and I'm going to tell you something. God has opened many, many doors for me that way. And I think if we go out as a church, the greatest time I ever went out, I was the education director of Westside Baptist Church. I had 27 teachers, and I made them all go with me. Let me tell you something. When 27 adults are walking down the street, people want to know what's going on. We made the most connections we ever made that day. It was wonderful. So if it's just a few, fine. But the more, the merrier. Amen. Let's get out here and pray for this community. Let's pray God's going to. Why? You know, I don't want to come here every Sunday and just be a family with you guys. Okay? That would be good enough for me, Kathy, because I do love you guys. It would be. I don't think it's good enough for God. I think He's called us to something, and I believe each one of us have a purpose to fulfill that. So if you can't come and walk this neighborhood because of illness or this or that, fine, okay? Or if you're too shy, maybe, or something, I understand that too. But there's telephones, there's prayer. You know, if you don't want to knock on doors and meet people, just walk with us if you're healthy enough and pray with us in this community. Let's break the chains that the enemy has bound this community with. Amen. And in saying that, I think I took too much time. I did good? Did you respect me in it?
Yes, always.
Okay. This Saturday. It's every second Saturday. Okay? All right. Was I supposed to pray? Who's up next? Harry, you pray. Get up there, Harry.
You blew him out already. You know what? I know he blew him out for a long time too, and I don't know, maybe we family and everything. I say Brother Matt, I say Pastor Matt. I don't know why. That's myself, you know, feel good, feel, I don't know, you know, feel good, say Brother Matt, you know. I know it, it's our pastor, but you know what? I don't know, feel more like a, you know, more power, more like a, he understands me and everything. So, oh, good, we good. Like you, brother, you know? Yeah. Yeah, exactly, you know. I never had something like that before, you know. This is the first church that I've been. Thank you. I know everybody. And everybody knows me, my wife, you know. So, hey, feel happy. That's what it is, you know. And I'm so glad for the Bible study. But you know what? I work at night, so I try to speak in the day, but they say, no, they need me at night. So I'm the only one working at nights. I'm a maintenance guy. I'm a supervisor. I'm everything. So I'm doing everything, you know. So I say, oh, Lord, thank you. You know, it's not a complaint. Don't take it that way. It's not a complaint. it's just a job. And I do it for my Jesus, you know, for my God. So thank you, Lord, you keep me there. I know before it was a struggle going over there, but now I'm there. And everything is good. Everything is like, a, you know, everything fly away. So thank you, Lord, for that. Thank you, Caesar. Between that, I want to read Psalms 121. Salmo 121. Thank you, Jesus. I love this church. It's a family church, so. Feel so, you know, I can feel it in my heart. So I don't think nobody can take that from me. So feel good, strong, you know. Thank you, Jesus. Psalms 121. No problem. Amen. Oh, thank you. Say, I lift up my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from? So we know where they come from, you know. Thank you, Jesus. My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Number three, say, He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, say, He who watches over Israel will never slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade and your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor by the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. Amen. And number eight, they say, the Lord will watch over you coming and going. Both say now and forevermore. Thank you, Jesus. So we know now, it's not only here, no, it's all over. So just being with God, and you know, He's your strength, He's your all, everything you got. So thank you, Lord. Oh, Father God, I just saying thank you for this beautiful day, Lord, you know. Just, Lord, just keep us safe over here and my family church praying, you know, every day, every night, Lord, you know. Just keep them safe and everything, Father God. Thank you, Lord, for everything you give us, Lord. Thank you for the for the blessings, Lord. Thank you for everything. Thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, amen, amen. We can say hello.
Good morning, Community Christian Church. Blessed is the name of the Lord. And guess what? October is the Pastor's Appreciation Month. Pastor's Appreciation Month. And today, we're not just appreciating our pastors, our leaders, the deacons, and all of that. We respect them. We love them. We pray for them. And we cover them with our prayers. Yes, yes, that's it. Oh, praise the Lord for the leaders of our church. You know, when I was reminded to that yesterday. She said, wow, Pastor's Appreciation Month. Yes, Lord, give our pastors that grace to lead. That the leaders to lead us to the path of righteousness. That we're going to grow in and mature in Christ. So we bless our pastors, we bless our leaders, and we are so thankful for their lives. Glory to God. In Jesus' name, amen. All right. Oh, Lord, this is what our pastor and leaders are. They follow Jesus. All right, let's open our Bible in Luke 9. Praise the name of the Lord. Oh, it's nice to see the young people over here. We welcome you to the Community Christian Church. We love you to be here and bring your friends next time. Glory. Yes. When I'm here in the front, I have the joy of the Lord I can't contain. So you know it, right? Okay. So let's open our Bible in Luke 9. 9. Okay. And we'll start reading from verse 21. Verse 21. So here, Jesus predicts his death. Verse 21 says, oh, before that, Father, thank you so much for your presence today. Thank you for the joy of the Lord in this place. Thank you for that overflowing love, just like what we sang this morning, that really, Lord, captures every heart because you are here, Lord. You are the God of love. Thank you, Lord, for the perfect peace that comes from you. Thank you, Lord, for joy overflowing and rejoicing in our hearts. And thankfulness, for this is the day that you have made. We have always to rejoice and be glad in it. And we bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord, in this place. Because you are holy, you are mighty, you are our loving, ever-gracious God. And thank you, Lord, that the word today will come alive, active, and will bring, Lord, that refreshment, that we are going to be recharged. We're going to be edified, O Lord. And we praise you for the presence of the Holy Spirit, who will speak through us through the messages. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, so verse 21 says, Jesus strictly warned them not to tell this to anyone. This is about when Peter acknowledged him as the Messiah, as revelation to God, and he said, who said I am? And Jesus said, you are the Messiah, the Son of God. That's why this verse here in 21 says that we are not to tell this to anyone. And he said, the Son of Man must suffer many things and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the teachers of the law. And he must be killed on the third day, be raised to life. 23rd, then he said to them all, whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take up their cross daily and follow me. 24, for whoever wants to save their life will lose it, but whoever loses their life for me will save it. What good is it for someone to gain the whole world and yet lose or forfeit their very self? Verse 26, whoever is ashamed of me and my words, the Son of Man will be ashamed of them when he comes in his glory, in the glory of the Father of the holy angels. 27. Truly I tell you, some who are standing here will not taste death before they see the kingdom of God. Thank you, Lord, for your word, Lord, this morning. Thank you so much. This is this very scriptures that we just read this morning. There's also, we have the synoptic gospel, and we could see that also in Matthew 16:24, in Mark 8:34. So when you see that, the same the same scriptures, but they look at it in a perspective where it makes the whole scriptures complete for all of us. Glory, because they don't contradict with each other. They're just united in the message. So with that, yes, follow Jesus. And when he said here, whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take up their cross daily. That's daily. And follow me. So taking up the cross means that you are denying of yourself. You are crucifying that old flesh nature. You died of old self. That's why when we became born again Christian, who repented our sins, who made Jesus Christ as our Lord and our Savior, who stay in our word and continually obeying the word of God and continually living it as a witness for him, then we will be able to share him, that we are not going to be ashamed to share the gospel to others. Why we're so ashamed when Jesus Christ on that cross tell him that I'm not ashamed of you, I love you. Now, what we are going to do? As the children of the Most High God, you're going to be proud that you are the child of God. Are you proud to be the child of God? Yes, it is the kind of pride that is a good pride. Because you want to know your Father's business. You want everybody to know that Jesus Christ is the only way, the truth, and the life. That Jesus Christ bought me and delivered me from the sting of death. I'm now standing here just like you and me. You are now sitting there because Jesus Christ loved you and purchased you by his blood. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So that, you know, that when we are following Christ, we are focusing on Christ. Look, when you are following with somebody, you have to follow the direction. So now what are the directions that we are following here? And these directions, the roadmap to eternal life. Roadmap to eternal life. Glory to God. Now, if you are outside, yes, today is that I will follow Jesus here in the church on Sunday. All right? And when you go out, who are you following? All right. That's it. Follow Jesus. Yes? The young kids from the mouth of the kids. Glory to God. Yes, self-denial is linked with carrying the cross. We have to crucify this old self. And then, yes, Jesus Christ died for you and me on the cross. Why is that so? Because he loves you so much. He loves you so much. And the cross you carry has to do with the choices. We have our own cross to carry. That's why he said, deny yourself and take up their cross. Daily, daily. Now, if you're taking up your cross daily, okay, you make that choice, that decision to make right before the Lord. Yeah, when people persecuting you, are you a Christian? Why you're behaving that way? Why you are responding that way that you should fight the world does? But you said, no, I will not fight the battle of the world. I will fight by bending down my knees and looking up to my Father, because my Father is going to fight for me. Yes. You know, that's the thing. All of us that experience how God fights for us. And he said, be still and know that I am God. Glory to you, Father. Yes, it's the choices and your will, the responses you have, and the actions, and foremost of all, our characters and the attitudes you carry in your heart. The cross means that you are putting to death every decision, every response, every attitude, every lust in your life that is not consistent by the love of God and is contradicting to the word of God. When the Bible says it is, believe it. Believe it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And our attitude anchors on the love of God. Now, this is very interesting. God does want you. He said when you carry the cross, God does want you to carry anything he has asked for you. He will not ask you to carry others' cross because you have to deal first with yourself. Look into your heart, look into your life, make it right before the Lord. And then You know, when you have that instruction from him, he will give you the grace to do it. But now, there's something that I'm also having this illustration in here. Okay. All right. I have a small cross, though. It's just an illustration. You know, I remember Matthew 7:3. Matthew 7:3. He said, if I'm going to carry my cross, sometimes you're too concerned about others. He said, I want to carry my cross. How about him? I want to carry his cross. I want to carry his cross. I want to carry his cross. But you're not dealing well with yourself first. You want to carry all the crosses of others, but you are not making it right before the Lord. That's why Matthew 7:3, why do you look at the speck of sawdust in your brother's eye and pay attention to the plank in your own eye? Sometimes we judge things, and then because of this message, the plank is going to be taken first in order for you to see better, to understand better, to see what are the cross that you are going to carry. The cross that we have is, you know, is good between us and God. And you're going, Lord, help me to carry my cross. Help me to carry my cross. If you try carry something God wants someone else, you know, Alex might be carrying his own cross. Pastor Matt will be carrying his own cross. Brother Paul will be carrying his own cross. And what God did with this is that he gave us the grace to carry that cross. Glory to God. And, you know, we take that daily. The grace of God to carry that cross is that our hands, the grace, the strength of God that comes from him to lift up and carry that cross. The grace on our shoulder to carry that cross. And the grace in our heart. The grace in our heart to live out the cross in our daily life. It is through the grace of God. That's why his grace is enough. His grace is sufficient for all of us. And we need that grace. The grace to overcome. The grace to conquer. The grace to understand him and have the wisdom of God of what will be the right thing to do. His grace, we need that daily. And we need tons of that grace, actually. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That it is only through the grace of God that we're able to follow him consistently, truly, and following him. And also sharing to others so that they will also follow. Follow Jesus. Okay, let's follow Jesus. But it's only through the grace of God. And we're so thankful for that grace that he has given us daily. Yes, the grace of God that makes the bearing of the cross possible. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And again, you know, when we have all this grace, Lord, we thank you that your grace is enough. You're sufficient. And with that, Lord, we thank you that you give us your grace daily. You equip us, Lord, with your grace daily. You give us, Lord, that grace to understand, to know you more, to build that relationship, and foremost of all, Lord, to follow you consistently, daily. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Praise God. His grace is enough. Praise God. Yep. The Father and Son. Praise the Lord. Church, I have one question to you today. Are you ready to praise the Lord? God gave us the grace to sing. God gave us the grace to worship God today. And because of that abundant grace, I praise you, Lord, that today's singing will be a delight to your heart, coming from the hearts, Lord, of your people, from the Community Christian Church. Yes, Lord, you are, Lord, our Messiah. That's why we sing, Lord, to Zara. Oh, we'll lift up, Lord, our hearts to you. We acknowledge you, Lord Jesus, are our Messiah. We acknowledge you, Lord, as the source of grace, as our sustainer, Lord. Your grace is enough for all of us. Yes, Lord Jesus, you are our Lord and our Savior. You died
You have risen and you will come again soon. That's why you give us the grace, Lord, to wait. You gave us the grace, Lord, to wait upon the Lord. And while we're waiting for you, we'll keep on singing, worshiping, serving you, Lord. And Psalm 24:7-8 says, lift up your heads, ye gates. Be lifted up, your ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. Yes, the King of glory is in this place. And his name is Jesus Christ, the one true God. Glory to you. Hallelujah. And now, Lord, your people sing, Hosanna in the highest. Glory to you, Father. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, amen. Yes, church, stand on your feet. Let us sing. Remember, we have abundant grace right now to sing. Let us sing with all our hearts to the Lord. Glory. Hallelujah. sing this out loud, church. Hosanna to the highest.
Hosanna, Hosanna.
Aren't you glad that there was a Lamb of God that shed his blood for you? I am. That's why when we sing this song, the Lamb of God, Anna's Day, he said, Lord, you are worthy of every praise, of every thankfulness, of everything, Lord, that we are doing for you. Because today, Lord, everything that we do, from the praise and worship to the meditations and even to the messages, oh Lord, we do that for you to glorify you. We thank you, Lord, that you are worthy, Lord, the Lamb of God who was slain, to receive power and wealth and wisdom and strength, honor and glory and praise. That's why when we read Revelation 5, we know about this, the sacrifice that Jesus Christ have done, and the victory in Christ, the Lamb of God. He is not only the slain Agnus Dei, but he's also the victorious risen Agnus Dei, and the conquering Agnus Dei that will be coming to his church will come for you. Glory to God. Hallelujah to our Almighty God who reigns forever and ever. Yes, Lord Jesus, worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Glory to God in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
This morning. Thank you that we breathe in your presence. You fill every heart, Lord, with your presence. Thank you, Lord Jesus, because this ground is a holy ground. This is the place of worship, and your people would like, Lord, to give you all their praises and honor and worship to you, Lord. Yes, Lord, let church, let us praise him. Praise him. We praise the Lord my God with all my heart, and we will glorify his name forever. The name of Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus, thank you so much, church, brethren, glory. Whatever you are undergoing right now, God knows it. He is with you and let you know that I will not leave you nor forsake you. I love you with all my heart. Glory to God. And I am with you. I will walk with you. I have my grace for you. Stay trusting in him, church. Stay believing in his word. Stay in the word of God and trust him. Trust him no matter what life brings. His love is rescuing. His love is redeeming. Praise him in good times. Praise him in the storms. He is our peace. He is our rest, and he is our deliverer. Glory to God. Praise you, glory. Yes, Lord Jesus. Glory to Jesus Christ, our King. Glory to your Father in Jesus' name. Amen. Glory, glory. Oh, praise him. Church, let's praise God. Let's praise him right now. Glory.
Turn your ears to heaven and hear the noise inside, the sound of angels' song, the sound of angels' songs, and all is for a king. We could join and sing all to Christ the King. How constant, how divine, this song of hearts will rise. How constant, how divine, this love of hearts will rise.
Sing it out, church.
He is holy. angels join in singing, all for Christ the King. Oh, oh, praise Him. Oh, oh, praise Him. He is holy. He is holy. Oh, oh, praise Him. Oh, oh, praise Him. He is holy. He is holy. La, 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 la.
The grace to sing out loud to the Lord. Yes, He's worthy for all our praises. He's worthy for our worship. And our Lord is mighty to save. Do you believe that, church? Our Lord is mighty to save. That's why Zephaniah 3:17, yes, our God is mighty to save. He is. Now, church, is like what I'm saying here is that if you are facing heavy trials of your faith, are you losing your hope? Remember, our God is mighty to save. He will able to change the circumstances from impossible to possible. He is able to make things happen. He could calm the storms in your life right now. He could calm the raging winds that come to you right now. And He could make a way. He's a way maker. He's a breaker. He's anointing with the power of His Spirit. He's a bondage breaker. Glory to God. And He can make a way, and you could bring you and I to get through from everything that we are facing every day of our lives. Yes, He is mighty to save. He can move the mountain. That's why, church, stay trusting on His promises. Our God is faithful. Our God is always faithful. And hold on fast to His hand, who's going to lift you up, who's going to bring you the breakthrough and the victories. Glory to God. As we prepare ourselves for the Lord's Supper, let us remember the mighty God who saves. The mighty God who saves us from darkness, and now we are in the light, walking into the light, and being the children of the light. Oh, Lord Jesus, thank You. Lord, right now, Lord, we surrender. We surrender, all Lord, to You. We surrender our hearts to You, oh God. As we sing, there's Almighty to save. Yes, Lord, Help us, Lord, give us the grace that each of us in this Community Christian Church congregation will shine our light brighter each day, all for the glory of the risen King, Jesus Christ. Amen. Glory. Our God is mighty, He is, and forever, forever mighty, glory.
Everyone needs compassion, a love that's never failing. Let mercy fall on me. Everyone needs forgiveness, the kindness of a Savior. The hope of nations. Savior, He can move the mountains.
Why?
My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save forever. Author of salvation. He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave.
Thank you, Lord.
So take me as you find me, all my fears and failures. Give my life to follow everything I believe in. Now I surrender. I surrender. A Savior, He can move a mountain. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save. Salvation, He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. My Savior, He can move a mountain. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save. Forever, author of salvation. Jesus conquered the grave.
life of God shining.
For the glory of the risen King. And Jesus, shine the light and let the whole world see. We're singing for the glory of the risen King.
So I'm going to be in Luke 11:29. There it is. Now it's on the board. Okay, we got a few Bibles still turning. Alright. And it says, as the crowds increased, Jesus said, "This is a wicked generation. It asks for a miraculous sign, but none will be given it except the sign of Jonah. For as Jonah was a sign to the Ninevites, so also will the Son of Man be to this generation." You see, not just that, if you actually go back and it says, ask for a miraculous sign, if you go down and you read throughout the past and throughout everything about the Jews, they were asking with the wrong motives. And so if we actually ask for the right motives and we're actually seeking God in it and we're actually using the knowledge of God through it all, we actually will have an answer. The answer is always there, whether it be an answer we want or an answer that we don't even see. It's always there, though. We just have to keep our eyes open for an answer. And so it says, the sign of Jonah, for as Jonah was a sign to the Ninevites, so also will the Son of Man be to this generation. Later on, Jesus comes down, and everyone knows the entire story of it. He came down, he lived a life, he preached, he did miraculous signs, so many things. And he ended up dying on the cross and buried for 3 days and rose again. That's the small part, the gist of it. But if you actually think about it, Jonah also was buried in a well, buried technically, for 3 days, the same exact time that Jesus was in the ground. And then he came out and he actually went to the Ninevites and he warned them about what they were doing. God came down and he warned us, or Jesus, but he's also the Father and the Spirit, because 3 in 1. But he came down and warned us, just as Jonah warned the Ninevites. And so he came and he warned us all. Now, what are we doing? It says we're a wicked generation. That's really sad. If we're sitting here, we've heard the word, we've heard the entire warning signs and everything, but we're still sitting in it. We're still sitting in the same sin that we were doing yesterday and the day before. It's a wicked generation. That's why we actually got to go out and preach the word, and that's why we got to go out and spread the message, because if we don't, we're going to be sitting in there and he's going to look at us and he's like, "You're such a wicked generation." It's just going to be the same thing over and over again. We want to be more like the Ninevites, who actually repented, put on sackcloth, did ashes. They completely repented from everything they were doing, because they didn't want to be destroyed like Sodom and Gomorrah. So we got to repent. We got to put our full hearts into it. We got to lay it down. An offering. May the men come forward. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for having us just be able to have that warning sign and be able to have an ability to repent, Father, and just help us through it all, Father, because we all know that none of us are perfect, but we can be made perfect through you, Father. And just help us just to become more perfect in you, Father, and help the everything that goes on tonight, Father, the messages and everything, Father, just have your hand in it like it always is, Father. In Jesus' name we say, amen.
Amen.
And he took the bread, gave thanks, and broke it, and gave it to them, saying, "This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after the supper, he took the cup, saying, "This is the cup of the new covenant in my blood, which is poured out for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
Today we're going to be in Ephesians 5, starting at verse 8. it says, "For you were once in darkness, but now you are light. In the Lord, live as children of light. For the fruit of light consists of all goodness, righteousness, and truth. And find out what pleases the Lord. Have nothing to do with the fruitless deeds of the darkness, but rather expose them. For it is shameful to even mention what is disobedient. Do in secret." Thank you. "Day the pastor helps me. What a day. But everything exposed by the light becomes visible, for it is light that makes everything visible. This is why it is said, 'Wake up, O sleeper, rise from the dead, and Christ will shine on you.' Be very careful, then, how you live, not as unwise but as wise, making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is. Do not get drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the Spirit. In our flesh, we are nothing but darkness. So how can we be filled with the Lord, except by the grace of Jesus Christ for what he did on the cross for us?" Because if we go back to 5, starting at verse 1 and 2, "Be imitators of God, therefore, as dearly loved children, and live a life of love, just as Christ loved us and gave himself for us as a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God." Be imitators of Christ. In our flesh, we couldn't do this. We would fall short every time because we're so weak and we fall into sin. Sometimes it's unintentional. Other times we see it clearly, yet we still go into it. But in Christ, who gives us strength, and in his Spirit, we can do all things. So in his Spirit, we can overcome our sin. And we have to empower our spirit to overcome our flesh. And that's a battle for each day. "Wake, O sleeper, rise from the dead, and Christ will shine in you." It's up to us to see how long we're going to be sleeping. Because Christ is ready to shine in us as long as we permit him to. Because he doesn't force himself on us. He doesn't do anything to push us. Instead, he's right there, the patient father, sitting, waiting for us. And when we're ready, we just take his hand and walk with him. Because that's all he really wants. In terms of monetary value, he doesn't need anything. He's God. He's the one who provided it for us. To do that, we have to offer our hearts and give it as an offering. But that's only if we're prepared in the heart and the Spirit is calling us to do so. So instead of that, prepare your hearts and offer that to God first. So with that, may the man come forth. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you for your provision in our life, Father. Through you, we gain so much. And we just need to glorify you, Father, and seek you through all things, and offer our praise, Father. We just thank you for helping us and walking with us through this life, Father. And we ask that we might be more able to see your work, Father, as we pay attention to the small things that you provide. Just let us be more aware of your presence, Father, and let us glorify you throughout our lives as we walk with you. We thank you for all things in Jesus' name.
Thank you. Thank you.